God surprises earth with heaven. In the birth of this child, in the midst of a time when the Romans controlled everything that people were doing and thinking and saying, in the midst of all that, a child is born, not a general, not a king, not someone who's coming to check on our technology. A child, a baby is born to bring us the good news. The good news that no matter what we see all around us, no matter what they see all around them 2,000 years ago, no matter what, heaven is here. This is the realm of God, right here. And we find it when we pay attention to this Gospel of Luke, when we pay attention to the invitation to let the Spirit be with us, fill us up. When we stop long enough to listen, the angels have returned to heaven, the shepherds have gone back to the fields, the magi have returned to the place they came from, and life is here. And love is here, and the Spirit is here, no matter what else is going on. No matter the long list of resolutions you may or may not have listed. No matter which presents you gave, no matter which presents you received, no matter which presents you didn't receive. God is with us always. Love is with us. Always. In these babies being cuddled in the corners, in the children working on projects in the back, in the ushers making sure we all find our way, in Joycelyn making sure we've got a bulletin to lead us through, and Claudia leading us through this service, and the Recorder Society bringing us this wonderful music that makes us want to return to the Middle Ages and dance to these very simple, lovely, beautiful tunes. It is here. It is among us. Okay, so there were a few meltdowns over the holidays. And maybe you can claim one or two of them. But so what? It's okay. We're here. You're here. Love is here. The Spirit is among us and will guide us. Now, some of you might imagine that in the past few weeks, I've been kind of paying attention to the journey I've been on for the past 18 years. It was 18 years ago that I began my first call as a minister in a local parish. Tiny little church. And if it were filled, it could hold no more than 150 people. And that's the people actually sitting right next to each other. No one. Tiny little church. But that's where I began. And when I began, I remembered some of the things that I learned in that long, long journey I had in seminary, because I was never going to be in parish ministry, so I could take forever to get here. One of the things I learned was that you begin to understand what you believe through preaching. That's a bit scary. What are you doing on your first sermon? And even scarier, it continues to change. Right? I mean, not so much change, full-throated change, but evolve, right? More nuanced, right? And so I reflect back on these 18 years in parish ministry and the things I've gotten to learn through doing. And it's been a gift. It's been a gift to be able to stand here in front of you and speak from my understanding of the text, from my understanding of what's going on in the world, and my understanding of what's going on among us and within me. The other thing I learned, and perhaps I learned it even more deeply here, is that I must, if I am going to be at all effective as a pastor, I must be willing to trust the Spirit, to be with us and to be with me. You might remember, it was probably the first year or so that I was here. Sermons were always written out. That hadn't been the case, actually, before I got here. I mean, they had been written out, but this was a different exercise. And I realized in that because I am a very contextual pastor, I was getting grounded in the context. And so I needed a piece of paper. And then I began to realize over time that that piece of paper was confining me. I needed to see you, not the paper. And so I went from the paper, the text fully written out, to an outline. And the outline was still confining me. I was still needing to look at the paper. And then I went to notes. And then I got really frustrated because that wasn't working either for me. Because I couldn't see you like I need to see you. And so the Sunday after Joel Scheffel died, I remember it well. Because Joel had to struggle. Joel was a person with some disabilities, and he had to struggle in the world, and he had to trust in the world. And so that Sunday, I came in with nothing but the book. Nothing. Now, I assure you, I had probably a dozen pages of notes, but those were in a folder in my office. That's as close as they got after that. And I remember coming in and stepping down and telling you, I was scared. I was flying without a net. And I trusted that if I fell, you would catch me. And you have, every Sunday when I step down. Catching. Part of that catching is that you're present. You're here with me. You have been on this journey with me, and even if you come once or twice a year, you have been with me. You have been part of this. I know some of your stories. That helps me be connected to what's going on here. So here we are on a Sunday when we focus on new beginnings. New beginnings always mean endings, right? If we're moving in a direction, there's something behind us that comes with us in our memory, but we have to let go of it enough to move into that future. As I've said here, and I've said in the tidings, and I've said probably in council reports, I don't really know what the future is going to bring for me or for you. I do know this. We have been faithful in this journey. You have been faithful. I have been faithful. I do know this. The Gospel of Luke speaks to us when it says, the Spirit is with us. If we can trust that Spirit, I know that you will thrive. And I know that I will thrive, and that God will be with us. So as we move closer to this time when we bid adieu to each other, and we still have time, when we move closer, I hope we'll make room for the Spirit to be among us. I hope we'll make room for the stories that need to be told. We're going to have two gatherings that are very intentional, right? We're going to have a gathering on January 21st in the afternoon with the wider community, and we've invited the wider community to come in and tell stories about what it has meant for them to be in the community with Pilgrim Church. What difference it has made for them. And we will say to them what difference it has made for us that they've been with us too, right? There are times when they've come in here intentionally to hold us up when we've been attacked. The work we do can't be done in a vacuum. The work we do is hard enough to do without knowing we've got friends and allies who are with us. That will be an important day. I hope you will be here. And on February 3rd, the day before I finish my ministry here, we will gather as faith community at the nursery school in the afternoon and tell stories. Tell stories about the work we have done over these past years together. And hold each other up and lift each other up and celebrate what we have done. That will be an important time for us. That's part of the moving into the future, when we can look back and say, oh wow, look what we've done together. And look what the future invites us into. I don't need to tell you it's December 31st. Some of you are going to go out and party tonight. My husband and I have a tradition, now that we have grandchildren. And the tradition is this. Whatever grandchildren are available, spend the night with us. And we begin the countdown, usually with New York, because someone... New York? Is that the right way to go? New York. Oh, probably before that, because we've got young ones, yes. So we'll have to do the world clock and figure this out, but... You know, long before the new year comes in, we actually celebrate the new year and then take the youngest to bed. And then we celebrate the new year again and take the next one to bed. And then we celebrate the new year again and take the next one to bed. Jim and I almost never make it to midnight, but it's a wonderful way to start the new year. I hope that each of us, regardless if we're going to a party, with hats and whistles, or we're going to stay home, read a book, climb into bed early, knowing that the new year will come regardless. I hope we will make room, each of us, for the Spirit that God gives us, that helps lead us into our future. A future in which God will love us even more, each of us.